Hope you've got that winning attitude, driver. Where we left off. As you know, we're sticking to urban terrain for the next event, but we're kicking the intensity up a notch. Motorfest has provided Donut Media with two incredible cars.
Listen up, you buff horses. I've got 7 questions that you need to answer by getting behind the wheel of some of the most iconic cars the world has ever seen.
Knowing James, you can be sure. Is a validation event, meaning you'll need to use the skills you've acquired on the playground. Scotto wants to see if you can use them in a time attack.
Thank you.
event, replaced by a fully modified third-gen Camaro. Hoonigan created this car at Chevrolet's own request. The brand wanted a special car for a special engine, a 632 freight engine, also called a big block. Hard to miss, this engine literally pierces the hood. Actually, it doesn't even have a hood.
Thank you. Hey, welcome to the first test, the volcano. We really spruced up the place. The plan's simple. You go up to the summit, then drive down as fast as you can while performing. Such a challenging environment. You're probably wondering, why a chopper? You'll find out soon. Time to see what you've learned. Finish the race on time, do as many tricks as you can, and on top of winning that money, you'll win my heart. Deal? That big block is ultra powerful, and that's not a euphemism. But she's not a natural-born Gymkhana machine like the Hunaport. You can drift the streetcar for sure, but it's at your own risk with the handbrake. Yeah, you're gonna jump over it, like now. Now that's what we call proximity. This type of moment in a video with slow-mo? Now that's badass. Remember, align properly to take the rail. Designed this path in reference to hill climbs, hardcore uphill races. But in a volcano, dude, you take it up a notch. Come on, I want to see you flirt with the precipice a little longer. Kill these tires. We'll be right back. Watch out for roadworks. 100 meters ahead. Slaloming at high speed through roadworks, jumping over a chopper, that's why gymkhanas exist. Follow the chopper, the end is right over there. Well done. That time attack was crazy and honestly not very easy to negotiate, especially in a 1,000 horsepower Camaro. This machine owes its power to the extremely prominent 632 big block coming through the hood. We also beefed up the drivetrain, specifically going with straight cut gears, because Gymkhana drivers tend to be a little hard on their equipment and break everything. And by the way, we shot a couple highlight videos. I figured you might want to watch them. This race, it had its wow moments, but the others, they're gonna need to be even more spectacular than that. I need you to go pick up this Mitsubishi Evo 9, and then you gotta bring it back to the shop so Ron, the rally guru, and the boys can jump on it and get a build going.
In a parking lot a little further on. You just have to take it back to the Hoonigan HQ so that they can give it their special treatment. Customization is their thing.
To find this Evo in this area. It's quite rare in the US, so I had to jump on it. I've told Ron, and the team can't wait to get their hands on it. And what's more, we've got a sunset and great sound, everything smiling on us. Chill out a bit. This car doesn't look like much. Just look at the interior. No frills, classic Japanese minimalism. But there's always more. Mitsubishi gave us a nice inline four cylinder with already 280 horsepower. That, we're gonna turn up a bit. This bad boy is gonna make an absolute Gymkhana beast. We just need to give it a Hoonigan touch. I think we add a little carbon to it, a good way to give it some street spirit. Like a carbon hood, roof, and four doors. Did I say a little carbon? I meant a lot. Creating a Gymkhana car is always exciting. You start with an idea, toss in some passion, fantasy, and insanity, and you get the ultimate car. Back to the Hoonigan HQ. Thanks for your help, appreciate it. Ron's inside. He's gonna take care of Mademoiselle.
It never happened.